And hello again, Internet. As you should be able to see on the screen here, today's episode is going to be Star Trek, the 25th anniversary. The reason for this is this year, in fact, just coming up in about a week or so, is going to be the 50th anniversary of Star Trek. The pilot episode aired back in 66, early September. 50 years ago, the series has continued on to this very day with the movies by J.J. Abrams, which, yeah, some people like, some people don't. I think they're, at least the first two were okay. I have not seen the third one. Now, this game here, I have had since I had my first CD drive. It came with the Interplay 10th anniversary disc. This version here is available on GoG. This nice splash screen here is from GoG. I have never finished this game. In fact, I have barely played it because, quite frankly, last time I tried, it was a bit of a shit show. I'm not very good at this type of game. I really am not. So I'm hoping that I don't completely just mess everything up. But I probably will, and that's what you want to see, right? Hey, hey. Anyway, this game was released 24 years ago. Yeah, it missed the actual anniversary by several months, but that's fine. And this version that GoG has, and I believe it's the same with my CD, I'm not entirely sure, which is another reason why I want to use the GoG version, this is based on the CD re-release. And what that had, you'll see very shortly, because it was originally on disc, and when CDs came out, well, it let them put all this data on them. And you have to realize, original floppy disks, well, the original floppy disks were really bad, but the 3¼-inch floppy disks that most people think of when they think floppy disks, which are, you know, hard-shelled floppy disks, could hold 1.44 megabytes. Now, considering today we do things in terabytes, which are a million megabytes, yeah, that data has come a long way. But going from floppy disks to CD represents the single biggest jump we've ever had. Because we came from 1.44 megabytes to 650 megabytes. You could put 400 disks or so on one CD. Mind-blowing. So let's see what they did with that space, shall we?
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its mission? To explore strange new worlds, to discover new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before.
And yes, that is William Shatner. Enhanced CD-ROM. That's what they added. They actually got the crew, or the cast rather, from the original show to come in and voice their lines in this. That's amazing. I'm glad they did that. And I can't wait to see what it does. Okay. I know nothing of these controls. This is going to be great. Alright, this is going to loop this again, so let's get into the game.
Demon World.
Demon World.
Though the Enterprise's primary mission is peaceful exploration, the galaxy holds many surprises. To be prepared, we are conducting a mock battle with the USS Republic.
Captain Patterson reports the Republic is in position and ready to begin, Captain.
I've turned my volume down a bit.
Weapons and raising shields. I suggest we do the same, Captain.
Arming weapons and shields. How do I do that? Is there anything I can click? Can I do anything here? Okay, well, looks like the guy's behind me. If I push buttons. Oh, there we go. Ah!
Computer estimates the Enterprise's warp drives have overloaded and exploded.
Not my engine!
It's just a simulation, Scott.
Captain Patterson says better luck next time, sir.
Lowering shields and disarming weapons.
Message coming in from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
Jim, the Enterprise is ordered to travel to Pollux 5.
The natives report that alien life forms have been attacking the settlers near a mine at Mount Idol. You are to report to the High Prelate of the colony. The settlers are members of the Acolytes of the Stars sect. The description of the attackers vary, but all say that the attackers resemble creatures from many Earth religions known as demons. Starfleet wants to determine the nature of these creatures and to resolve the situation without bringing harm to the colonists. Starfleet out.
Okay, so how do I do that? No, really, how do I do that? Escape doesn't do anything. I don't see clicking doing anything. I can move the thing around the screen with the number pad, but I don't want to be on the screen. I want to... So I'm trying to figure this game out as I play, which is probably not the best idea. Yeah, I'm not...
Arming weapons.
No!
Disarming weapons.
Oh, okay, so W is weapons. That makes sense.
I don't know how long she can take it, Captain.
Engines.
She can't take it, Captain.
I advise referring to the star map and setting a course for the Pollux system, sir.
Okay, how about map? No, M doesn't work for map. So T was talk to
May
Spock, I guess.
May I respectfully remind the Captain that we haven't accomplished our mission, sir.
Thank you. Oh, P is pause. That makes sense.
Target analysis on.
A for
raising
analyze.
Shields.
S for shields.
Captain.
So S is shields, W is weapon. What the heck is D?
Aye, sir.
Shields repaired, Captain.
Oh, D is repair. Okay.
Orders are to proceed to the Pollux system.
Okay, H is help, I guess. What is this?
Captain's log.
No recent missions have been completed. So that's K does that. Oh, hey, oh, okay. Found the menu! Oh, really? There's no sliders here for the volume. It's either on or off. So I'm glad I turned my PC volume down. I hope you guys can still hear it. But I can't just quit that. Okay, so I have to go to K and then hit the Starfleet badge in order to bring up the menu. Oh, there's some archaic design right there. Z, X, C, computer. Help!
Topic not available, Captain.
Okay, well, C is computer. V, just makes my entire view, which takes away the bridge. And N! N is the thing. So what planet am I looking for? Oh, no! No, I have to read the instruction manual to find out what planet is what?
Well, of course, Captain.
Instruments indicate that we have crossed the Romulan neutral zone.
Well, that's not what I wanted!
Romulans materializing off the port bow.
Damage control standing by, sir.
Message from the Romulan commander, sir.
On screen, Lieutenant.
Enterprise, you are in violation of Romulan space. My orders are specific. Unauthorized Federation vessels are to be destroyed.
Unable to comply, Captain. We're under attack.
I can't warp out. Okay. Well, I can see over here is where he's going to be. Better raise my shields. Can I get out of here?
You can't take it, Captain.
I tried to use E to get away. Well, this is not working. I think... Because the map doesn't...
Unable to comply, Captain. We're under attack.
The map didn't bring up anything. I should have saved. I really should have saved.
Captain, the shields are up.
I can't transport the shields up. That's Star Trek stuff. Can I crush myself into the planet? Let's do that. Let's see what happens if I just fly right into the planet. Since I've already failed this miserably anyway. Yay! I can't. Oh, you can't crash into the planet. You just go around it. And of course, you can't do anything with these stars. They just fly right past, too. I don't know why there's all these stars, either, or why they're moving past you. These things should be a lot further away than the planet. Can I get out of here?
She can't take it, Captain.
Yeah, shut up, Scotty. They can never take it, can they? Alright, well, at this point, I have to do something to reload.
No game save.
There's no save games. I'll have to quit and start again.
Yes, quit the game.
Yes.
No, do not quit the game.
Yes, quit the game. Okay. I'm going to have to open the instruction manual. Fortunately, the GOG version comes with it. I'm sure my book does as well. But that's buried somewhere, and I don't want to dig it out right away. So, instruction manual. Da-da-da-da. Where are you? Where are you? Other. Manual. There we go. Now I have an instruction manual. It's got a star chart on it. I'm sorry you guys can't see this. There's a star chart! I will be referencing this. Put the game back up. There we go. You guys see everything all right again? Should be able to.
Space. The final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise.
Okay, well, let's do this intro thing again.
Demon World.
Demon World.
Enter the mock battle. Primary mission.
Captain Patterson report.
The Republic is arming weapons and raising shields.
Raising shields.
Arming weapons.
There. Okay, I should be able to stand a little bit more of a chance this time. Since I figured out what buttons do what. But I don't like the fact that the map is... Oh great, that's the planet. There you are. Still not very good.
It's just a simulation, Scott.
Captain Patterson says better luck next time, sir.
Lowering shields and disarming weapons.
Message coming in from Starfleet.
On screen,
Jim, the Enterprise is ordered
We've heard this already. Let's save.
Save new game.
Yes. Description. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, where am I supposed to be going again?
Orders are to proceed to the Pollux system.
Pollux system. Hit N to bring up the map. N for navigate. Okay, that makes sense. But you see, it doesn't tell us what any of these maps are. We don't have any indication of where the Romulan neutral zone is, which, you know, we should. It should be visible on this map. But no, I have to go out and look at the manual. Let me just double check
to make sure. I'm pulling this thing off my head. I'm going to quickly look through my box here, which I should have done this ahead of time. I apologize. I have this entire box.
There, put the mic back on. I have this entire box full of instruction manuals here that... Aha! That's the wrong one. And if that's the wrong one, then I don't have it in the box. Nuts. So I have to bring the computer one up. Yay, this is professional, guys. Totally professional. So I want to go to the Pollux system. Pollux system number 19 in the instruction manual. That is going to be right here. So, bring this window back up, and here we go!
We have arrived at Pollux 5.
Looks the same as the other planet. Now, because I actually made it to the right place, let's save it.
Save new game.
Yes, we'll save the new game. Okay. Let's warp down.
We're not in orbit, Captain.
Are you... How do I get to orbit? Do I just fly toward the planet? Well, let's fly toward the planet! Stop drifting. Is it really going to make me waste the time to fly toward the planet? Can I hit O to be in orbit? Yes, I hit O to go into orbit.
Entering standard orbit.
Yes. Okay. Now let's beam down to the surface.
Spock, come with me. Mr. Scott, you have the car.
That's not what transporting looks like.
This is so much better, gentlefolk. We are honored at your presence, and hope you will find peace here in our haven.
Captain, the flora on this planet is very interesting. I wonder how useful it may be for medicinal purposes.
Well, let's talk to this guy. No, I said talk to this guy. What are you doing? Oh no. Am I gonna have to... Yes, damn it. I'm going to have to... Every command I want to do, I have to tell it to do.
I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. We have received word that alien life forms are creating problems at your mining facilities at Idle Mountain. Tell me more. Most High Prelate and Given, I am honored to meet you. I consider it my divine duty to assist you in any possible way with the spawn of the devil.
Oh, okay, and I have to make the choice as to what to use.
Ghosts and boogeymen, eh? I find that a little hard to believe.
And pretty bad on splicing that line read there.
I'm Captain James T. Most been seeing ghosts and boogeymen, eh? I find that a little hard to believe.
Yeah, they spliced two lines together there, and transition not too good. Okay, well, let's
Captain
take the first
choice.
I'm
Captain James T. Kirk of the USS.
Certainly, Captain Kirk. Not aliens per se. We have encountered what we believe are demons at Idle Mountain. Creatures surely emerging from the very gates of hell. Our god would not test us thus without reason. So we believe your might and insight are our god's method to help us discover what is going on.
Aside from seeing demons, has any hard data been collected? Any evidence I could see? Demons? Gates of hell? This is the 23rd century. Aside from seeing demons, has any
hell,
hard data been collected? Any evidence I could see?
A skeptic would consider everything merely anecdotal or unproven. My people will gladly tell you their own stories, so you need not hear it secondhand through me.
What can you tell me about the mine itself? You're wasting the time of a starship capable of destroying this planet with campfire stories? No wonder you were dumped out here in the middle of nowhere. What can you tell me about
the mine
itself?
So I do have
the
choice to make Kirk be a complete dick. Ah, hey there, Morning Songs.
The area is exceptionally stable tectonically, and easy for our machinery to work in, praise God. We've mined for hafnium and a variety of useful trace elements. The deeper we dig, however, the more anomalous the variety of minerals seems to be. Our Ignatiate brother Stephen has his own theories about why this might be. Either way, the anomalies inspired brother Canberry to conduct studies inside the mine. Yesterday, he reported discovering a strange door. A gate to hell, surely, for the demons caused a cave-in immediately. Canberry was trapped, unconscious, and the demons prevent us from rescuing him. We can only hope he is still alive. Thank you for your courtesy, Kirk. May you receive the guidance and protection of our god as you complete this divine mission.
Okay. Ah, no, the K command is gone now. How do I save on the planet? Okay, well, T is talk. U is probably use. W brings me back to the basic walk, I guess. G, I have no idea what G does. L is look, I would assume. Oh no, there's no... Oh, okay, so I can push this to teleport back up, I guess. Ah, there's the menu, woohoo!
Save new game.
Yes, let's save a new game. Okay. Yeah, classic graphics adventure UIs. Let's look at the sign. Can I look at the sign? All mining equipment use this road. Thank you. Oh, can I look at these buildings?
A quickly constructed Spartan shelter, primarily used by fledgling colonies.
Are those mirrors then instead of windows? Because I thought these were greenhouses. And again, I guess they don't let a lot of light in. Walk. Wait, can I look at the plants down here?
Remnants of a recent snowfall cover the ground.
Well, thanks. I was looking at the plants.
On the other side of the trees is Idle Mountain, a tall, forbidding place. You have a vague feeling of danger.
Don't you tell me what kind of feeling I have. You speak in third person, not second. Is the rest of the party gonna come? Okay, there they are. Oh, hello, Romulans.
You get no response.
Oh, and they shot the red shirt. Hello? Do I have phasers?
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there. There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Do I have phasers?
You fail to obtain anything. Captain Kirk is fatally shot by a Klingon. Game over. Load a previously saved game.
You're right, they're Klingons, not Romulans.
But they don't have the bumpy forehead!
Okay, load the game, yes.
Restart the game.
No.
Load a previously saved game.
Yes, let's load the game. Yes, let's load name tag 2. What's my attack button? How am I supposed to defend myself? Game, why are you confusing? You think A would be attack, or P would be phaser, or, you know, S would be shoot. I can look.
James Tiberius Kirk, captain of the Enterprise. He's always happy to run an errand of mercy.
I don't know what G is supposed to stand for. Get? Yeah, okay. Get or give. Use you. Oh! Oh!
Aha!
Stun. Kill. Okay, was that hitting you twice that did it? Yeah, okay, yeah, okay. I have to assign it in my bag, into my hand. So I have to press U to use, then clip my weapon, and I have to do this before I get killed. You can see why I did not get very far in this game last time I tried playing it 20 years ago. Alright, off we go. Suddenly, Klingons!
You see a small explosion, and the Klingon's hand falls to the ground with a dull thud.
I guess they don't make Klingons like they used to, sir.
It's the Klingon's detached hand.
Well, okay, I was trying to look at it. I guess I have to, what, pick it up?
Captain, we register phaser fire and an unknown energy beam. Is everyone okay?
We're fine. Did you register any disruptor fire?
No, Captain. Why? Are there Klingons down there?
No, just an idea, Kirk out.
Fascinating. I begin to suspect that we have stumbled upon something that the colonists would never have uncovered.
What is it, Spock?
I wish to gather further data before making a definite conclusion, Captain.
You fail to obtain anything.
See, we're not that far from this being the midpoint of Trek's lifespan. Not quite sure what you mean with that.
You take the Klingon's detached hand.
Can I look at the bodies?
They look like Klingons.
They can't look very much like Klingons. Yeah.
This hand was taken from the Klingon outside.
Good!
The cave.
Can I examine it? Okay, how about I do this? Let's use my tricorder on the hand. No! Yeah, this marked the 25th anniversary. That's why I'm doing it now, because we're on the 50th. That was 25 years ago, actually. Ah, nope, bad. And the game actually came out 24 years ago, so it missed the actual anniversary.
Save new game.
No, let's save.
Cancel.
No.
Say, replace previous game.
Yes, replace a previous game. Name tag 2. Save it on that. Yeah, so this is the halfway point here. Okay. I have a hand. I can't examine... Well, maybe I can tell what these things
One
are.
One Starfleet issue medical tricorder to assure that Starfleet doctors make the correct diagnosis.
If nothing else, I can at least look at my items and make sure I'm looking
One
at the right
Starfleet
thing.
One Starfleet regulation phaser type 1, set to stun. One Starfleet issue science tricorder, a science officer's best friend.
Can we please use the tricorder on the bodies? Oh, can use the medical tricorder on the
bodies. One Starfleet issue communicator to allow landing parties to talk with their shipmates in normal circumstances.
So I get to at least see what my inventory does.
One Starfleet issue medical kit.
And I'm sure the Red Cross is all unhappy that their symbol is on this. As I've discussed before, the Red Cross for medical symbol far predates the Red Cross organization. So if they try making claims that, oh, you can't use that on a medical bag, they're full of it. Because they took the symbol because it already had this meaning. Well, let's back out of that. Let's use our tricorder, please, on bodies.
This is not a Klingon, Captain.
Thank you!
Not a real one. It is an organic construct, an android-like robot. It looks like a Klingon, but the appearance is entirely superficial.
I'm trying to remember when exactly Next Generation came out. I don't know if it came out before this or after this. So robots might not really be, or androids, might not have been a thing yet.
Yeah,
we already know that. Thank you. Okay, so I've scanned the body finally. I have the hand. I have no idea what the hand is. It wouldn't let me scan the hand. This game is annoying.
Replace.
Yes, replace that one. Can I look at the cave?
You see the mine entrance ahead.
Okay, well, it doesn't give me anything. Let's walk to the cave. And our red shirt is still alive. I don't know how that happened. Let's keep walking. 87-ish? That's possible. I don't remember the date. Okay, so we have a bunch of rocks and... Oh, this is the cave-in they were talking about.
A large pile of rubble blocks what appears to be a large metallic structure.
Okay. Is there any way to get rid of this rubble? I'm gonna just go ahead and do the basic Star Trek. Let's shoot it!
Captain, the structure is extremely unstable. I would not recommend disturbing the lower section before the upper sections have been cleared.
Thank you, Spock. Well, let's shoot the upper
section.
Assume
firing positions.
We're going to shoot the rock. It's going to land on the red shirt.
There is no apparent effect.
Captain, this course of action is ineffectual. That action would be completely illogical, Captain.
No, it wouldn't. I wanted to get rid of the rest of the rubble so I can get to the door. Yeah, I see him there. Oh, fine. All right, game. We'll do the medical tricorder on him.
This man is badly hurt and suffering from shock and exposure as well.
Thanks, Doc. Can we heal him?
It was a near thing, but he'll live.
Yay! He's alive! We did something useful. Let's save the game again because this game's gonna get annoying.
Save new game. Replace. Delete previous. Cancel. Save. Replace previous game.
Okay, let's talk to him. I'm getting the hang of the controls here. So yeah, 87 for TNG. So androids were already a thing in
oh,
lore.
Oh, thank you, kind souls, for saving my life. Let me rest here for a little before returning to report this miracle to Prelate Angiven. Oh, thank you.
Oops. Okay. Can we look at the door now?
A large metallic door is set in the structure. This looks like some of the hand security panels on the Enterprise.
Sir, it may be dangerous. Let me try it.
Bye, Red Shirt! It was nice knowing you!
I think I was shocked, sir.
Hey, he's still alive.
There's nothing at the moment for me to do there. There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Okay, how about can I scan the door thing? Oh! I have a hand!
The fit is perfect, but something seems to be shorting out.
Alright. Can I scan it then?
Nothing to report, Captain.
This looks like some of the hand security panels on the Enterprise.
Of course it would be shorting out.
A large metallic door is set in the structure. A cavern deep in Mount Idol.
Yeah, this look command is about as useful as it ever is. Thinking. Spock, you got any ideas? Which one's Spock?
I recommend as thorough an analysis of this area as possible.
Bones?
Jim, the next time you need medical help on a snowball...
Bones.
I'll probably end up coming along.
It doesn't sound like DeForest Kelly, but he did voice work on this game, so I don't know what's going on with that.
A pulsing red light is set in the structure above the door.
Let's scan. I mean, I got this freaking scanner. Let's use it!
Fascinating, Captain. This door is made of an unknown material. It is clearly built by an alien race we have no knowledge of. Nothing to report, Captain. Fascinating, Captain.
Look at the door.
I'm registering low-intensity shielding unlike anything we've encountered before. That kept this door, and whatever is behind it, hidden from the ship's sensors and earlier tricorder readings.
So how do I turn it off?
Fascinating.
I mean, there's still rubble in the way. But it wouldn't let me shoot the rubble anymore. Let's try to shoot the rubble again.
That's a phaser, not a flashlight, Jim. That's a phaser, not a flashlight, Jim.
Yes, I know. I'm trying to shoot the rubble.
Captain, the consequences of such actions may be catastrophic.
Jim, stop trying to shoot everything. That's a phaser, not a flashlight, Jim.
Yeah, I tried using it, and that's what... It tells me it shorted out. I guess I can try using it again. I mean, at this point, what's the worst that'll happen, right?
Nothing happens.
Yeah, see, nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. So I'm trying to figure out how to unshort the thing. Let's walk over to here. Do you have anything else to say?
Oh, thank you, kind souls, for...
No, you don't. Okay, well, what else is in this area? Nothing. I cannot go to that side of the screen. So basically all I can do is either try to open this door or go back and tell the dude what I found. Let's go back and talk to the guy. Since there's clearly nothing else going to go on in here. Jim, let's go. Walk over the robot corpses. He's gone! Well, nuts. Where did he go? Is he a robot too?
Save new game. Replace previous.
Can I go inside the buildings? Knock, knock. Yes, I can. Ooh, what's all this stuff?
I never dreamed that Starfleet would be interested in my discoveries, Captain. But our guard often surprises us.
That was it. That's all you had to say. Also, how come I can see outside these... Man, it could be one-way mirrors. Let's look around and see what I can see.
An old-fashioned computer. It appears to have some type of simulation running.
See, what's on the computer? Star Trek 25th and I've never heard of it.
Assorted pieces of glass rest on this table from ancient beakers to double burners. A multi-purpose workspace with fine, well-worn tools and equipment close at hand.
Why would the beakers have to be
ancient? A glass-fronted display of mineral specimens, including a meteorite, a few fossil shells, the skull of a cat-sized alien animal, and a very encrusted twist of metal. An antiquated molecular synthesizer sits in the corner.
It's a replicator. Well, let's do some scanning of our own, since I can't think of anything else to do at the moment.
Fascinating, Captain. It is an Ardac 4 molecular synthesizer, a museum piece in perfect working order. I read a collection of small items of no evident value. I would characterize this as a small museum display, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain. Residue of several different compounds are in the tubes. None of the compounds would explain the sightings. A vintage 80-12-86 of the mid-21st century. It is a fine museum piece.
Oh, how cute! They thought they were still going to be x86 computers!
Save new game. Replace delete preview. Replace previous game.
That's adorable! I mean, technically we're still kind of using the x86 architecture, but we stopped calling it that back at the 586. Oh, hello, people! Let us start talking.
I am worried about Brother Chubb. Can you examine him, Doctor?
What an unfortunate name.
This man is in no condition to talk.
What's the backwards legs? Are
he
you a satyr?
He is too busy consoling the wounded man. He is too busy
Okay, obviously I'm gonna have to... First, let's medical tricorder the dude.
Jim, this man has suffered severe physical injuries to his head and arm. The wounds have been adequately cared for. However, he has developed a Neugarian infection. If not treated swiftly, the effects can be fatal. The infection can normally be treated with hypodidoxin, but there's none on the Enterprise.
I may be of some assistance. The Lorexian berry grows near the mouth of the cave. If I could acquire it, I would be able to synthesize the hypodidoxin from the berry. Unfortunately, the demons prevent us from approaching the cave entrance. Perhaps you could retrieve it for me.
Well, let's go do that then. We are Starfleet. We are here to save lives and shoot robots. Wait. Okay, come on, keep going. Look for the berries. No, look.
These branzite pods add a nice touch to the local flora.
No, where are you going? Go back.
The path is surrounded by some beautiful shrubbery.
Bring me a shrubbery.
The path is surrounded by some beautiful... These are very beautiful.
I go forward more, I guess? Because here's the... Ah, there's the entrance. Okay.
Various types of berries grow amongst the bushes.
Get berry.
You have retrieved a sample of berries.
Let's make sure these are the right berries. Can't scan the things in my inventory. Why not?
These seem to be Lorexian berries, Captain. They have several medicinal uses, but Dr. McCoy would know more.
I think these are the berries I wanted, then. In which case, let's go! Back to town. Because like every point-and-click adventure game, we have to walk back and forth. Now, okay, if I talk to you again...
He is too busy consoling the wounded man.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, I see you found the berries. Meet me in my lab.
Where's your lab? Further down? No, it's the other building, isn't it? Okay, into the lab we go.
Welcome to my study. Feel free
to look
around.
I was already in here earlier.
My medical and scientific equipment is surely not so sophisticated as you're accustomed to, but if there's anything you wish to use, please feel free. Also, I would be interested in anything you might have to show me.
Well, I could show you the hand I found, but first off, let's give you the berry.
I never dreamed that Starfleet would be interested in my
Can I give? Oh, D isn't give. Okay, well, let's use berry on you.
The settings on the RDAC 4 have already been adjusted. Simply place the berry in the machine and the hypodytoxin will be synthesized.
All right, no problem. Let's put it in the machine.
The machine synthesizes a quantity of hypodytoxin.
We've got to get this to Brother Chubb as quickly as possible, Jim.
Fine, let's go do that. Back and forth, and back and forth, back and forth. You remember that on Star Trek, right? Where Kirk and the away team walked back and forth forever? Yeah, good times, good times. Hypodytoxin on Brother Grimm.
Thank you. You're most kind.
Okay. Let's scan you again, just to be certain.
This man has recently suffered a nasty but non-life-threatening wound. The damage has been adequately cared for. The man's vital effects are attributable to shock and stress.
So he's fine. He'll be fine. Can I repair him myself? No, not really. Same thing. Yeah, let's try talking now. Okay, talk to you.
Brother Candray was, or is, my partner. I was on the communications link when the demons caused the rockfall and silenced him. He said he'd found a strange door with devilish writing. Truly, he came upon the gate of hell itself.
I am Brother Grisnash. I went up the mountainside in solitary prayer, seeking to face my fears. Indeed, I found them. A bellowing Krognik demon with sharp teeth and a long snout descended upon me in a rush of wind.
Captain, a Krognik demon has a decidedly wolfish appearance. Brother Grisnash, is this not the traditional shape of the Evil One and his minions among Tellarites?
It is.
I believe this may be significant, Captain.
So what you're saying is Klingons are the devil.
I headed up the party that sought to rescue Brother Candry. Without warning, the demons appeared and attacked us as we approached the mine.
Can you tell us what they looked like?
Like the demons that have plagued devout folk since before our people left the Earth. Huge, muscular demons with ruddy skin. Truly the manifestation of evil. With bat wings, horns and talons and a pointed tail. God preserve us all. One tore open my arm and I surely would have perished, but for my companions who bore me back down the mountain.
The demons didn't follow you?
No.
Yeah, okay, there was a Next Generation episode where someone was pretending to be a demon. And I'm having a feeling that that's basically the storyline that we're doing here. That whatever is there...
Stephen, an initiate following the holy teachings with mind and soul alike. I believe the anomalous mineral readings in combination with evidence of ancient disturbances in this otherwise highly stable geologic location indicates previous habitation of the region eons ago.
Why, Spock, you two should get along fine. He sounds just like you.
I would be equally honored to discuss medicine with you, Doctor, as science with your Vulcan associate. Let me continue. I believe our God made humans, aliens, and demons all. If I could get a real demon into my study, I would bless our God for the opportunity, as I thank him for everything in this life.
You tread close to unholy knowledge, Brother Stephen.
I appreciate your prayers, Brother Roberts. Captain, if you and your people go up the mountain, I hope afterward you will visit me in my study, which is next door. I'm too old to make the trek myself, but I'm eager for knowledge. In return, I will offer you what insights our God grants these old eyes.
As I said, I think something is pretending to be demons, probably to protect whatever inside that door. And given that they were robotic, it's possible
Save
that what did
game.
It is
Replace previous
a robot
game.
Itself. Just, you know, going predictions and... It's kind of funny, I don't think Star Trek ever would have dealt with religion, so...
I am Brother Steven.
Same thing, spot. Isn't it? Yeah, same stuff.
You tread
Okay, you now? Can you talk?
I headed up the party that sought to rescue Brother Kandri. Without warning, the demons appeared and attacked us as we approached the mine.
Can you tell us what they looked like?
Like the demons that have plagued devout folk since before our people left the earth. Huge,
no, I think it's the same one, isn't it?
Skin,
yeah.
Truly
we've
the manifestation of evil. With
the demons didn't...
No. I headed up the party that sought to...
Can you tell us what they...
No,
looked
no,
like?
Don't keep doing it again. No! What are you doing?
The demons didn't...
No. I headed up the party that...
I think it glitched out on me here.
Like the demons that have plagued devout...
The demons...
No.
Okay, good. Stop doing that. Let's go back into the lab and see if we can do anything with this hand that I have. I said go to the lab. Sorry, I had my eyes away. I thought the game would actually do what I told it to. let's give you a hand.
What a fascinating piece of equipment. Highly advanced technology. You see here, it seems to have been damaged, however.
Yeah, I wonder how that happened.
Take it to my workbench and let's see if it can be repaired. I fear my hands are too shaky to perform such fine work, but perhaps one of you can do it.
Mr. Spock, see what you can do about that hand.
This machinery is delicate, but I have managed to repair the circuitry.
See, I can make it flip you off, sir. Okay, the hand has been repaired. I think the hand was what was shorting out before. So I should now be able to open that door. Fingers crossed that I've actually made some progress. Save the game, because I'm an idiot.
Save new
and I like to save constantly.
Game.
After what happened with previous games, do you blame me? Go up the trail. Go up the trail. In the hole. Starfleet go down the hole. Ah, he's gone. He must be the guy repaired. Okay. Fixed hand into security panel.
The hand circuitry triggers a connection and the door opens.
Yay! Progress. Save the game again.
Save new game. Replace
go in the hole. Keep going, Jim. Let's take a look around.
It appears to be an abstract piece of alien art.
You know, I wouldn't mind having something that looked like that. I really wouldn't. That looks kind of cool.
Many alien machines fill the room.
Keep saying alien. You're the aliens on this world.
Many alien machines.
Yeah, okay, we get it. I want that art though. Okay, is that it? There's nowhere else for me to go? Alright, time to bust out the tricorder.
Fascinating, Captain. It is a diagram of a lunar eclipse of this planet. See how the red sphere of the moon is casting a shadow on the blue sphere, Pollux 5. This must be a very old piece of work, because this planet's moon was destroyed thousands of years ago. The machinery is waiting for the gravitational pull of another eclipse to activate it. An eclipse that will never come. And one other thing, Captain. This
how does an eclipse change gravity?
Showing the proper settings on that control panel.
I have to actually see that again. I missed that. Okay.
The machinery is waiting for the gravitational pull of another eclipse to activate it. An eclipse that will never come. And one other thing, Captain. This may also be a diagram showing the proper settings on that control panel. It is an alien life support system, Captain, utilizing geothermal energy. It is still functioning, waiting for some sort of signal.
How does an eclipse change gravity? It doesn't. It's just light.
It is an alien life support system, Captain.
Okay, well. The settings are what? low, high, low.
It looks like a control panel with slide switches. This appears to control some unusual security equipment.
Okay, so there are actual panels to take a look at. Let's, well, take a look at them.
This control panel is a manual override for the alien life support equipment. This alien construction takes readings of mental activity. It also activates manufacturing equipment related to security and includes a short-distance transportation device.
What? Okay, let's go straight, just try to use this as it is. Is it gonna zoom in on it? Yes, it is. I kinda want this all the way up. This at about half. And this at... no. Well, okay. I think that shadow doesn't count. So that's gonna be at full, and that's gonna be at what, 1/6? Yeah. Because that's half. That's approximately 1/6, and that's gonna be full, so...
Nothing happens.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Now, I really hope that this shadow here isn't important, but we'll try it. Half. Half. 1/6.
Nothing happens.
Okay. Wait, what?
Nothing happens.
There is nothing at the moment from...
Okay, Spock? What the heck were you talking about?
Logically, the machinery is sustaining some type of life in suspended animation. If we can reactivate the machines, then we may be able to meet its creators.
Thank you, Spock, but that's not very helpful at the moment. This is what I'm worried about.
Captain. The machinery is waiting for the gravitational pull of another eclipse to activate it. An eclipse that will never come. And one other thing, Captain. This may also be a diagram showing the proper settings on that control panel.
Okay. So I have to try to figure out,
new game.
From that the diagram, previous... what the settings I'm trying to reach are. If I put it down at the bottom, it's full. If I put it at the top, it's full. At least all the lights. So what, there's 8 combinations I can do of full, half, and one? Is there any other clues for this? I don't see anything else. Alright, well, let's... It doesn't get any lower than one. Let's try that and see what happens.
Nothing happens.
Nothing. Okay. So low, low, high.
Nothing happens.
Low, high, low. It's kind of how it starts anyway, so could be it.
Nothing happens.
Low. I got no idea. I don't even know which ones I've done yet. I've already forgotten what order I was doing this in. Low.
Nothing happens.
Low, high.
Nothing happens.
Okay, I think I've done all the lows now. So, high, which I'm pretty sure I've already done. High.
Nothing happens.
High, low.
Nothing happens.
High, low.
Nothing happens.
High, low.
Nothing happens.
Okay, now I gotta assume that that's...
There's nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Now I'm gonna have to assume that this here is gonna be a half because of the shadow on it. I'm gonna have to assume that this shadow is actually important. So, high. I'm probably completely misreading what this is supposed to be anyway.
Nothing happens.
High, low.
Nothing happens.
There is nothing at the moment.
Yeah, shut up. High, low.
Nothing happens.
High, low.
Nothing happens.
Low, high.
Nothing happens.
Low, high.
Nothing happens.
Low, high.
Nothing happens.
Low. I think this is the last one now.
Nothing happens.
Spock, you're a liar. Can I do anything with this? Can I do anything with these? These don't move. What am I supposed to be doing here? Because it looks like this one, it looks like yellow is full bright. I'm pointing at the screen, that doesn't help you guys. It looks like this is supposed to be full bright. Because this shadow, I don't think, is actually part of the design, obviously. This, however, is obviously half light, half dark. This is one chunk dark, and it looks to be about 1/6. But I have tried every combination of full half one. I've even tried every combination of half, half, one. So if this is supposed to mean something, I don't get it. Spock's telling me it means something, but I got nothing. So I'm just going to try this.
Nothing happens.
Okay, well, I got nothing. You got any help for me, Spock?
Logically, the machinery is sustained.
I wonder who or what constructed all this.
You got nothing.
This appears to control some unusual security equipment.
Yes, thank you.
It looks like a control...
I can't use that.
This control panel is... This alien construction takes reading.
Yeah, we already know that.
It is an alien life support system, Captain, utilizing geo...
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
So the hand isn't useful.
Nothing happens.
This is why I don't do these games. I'm gonna go back and talk to the village and see if they've got anything. No, that's supposed to help you slide the things below. How? It makes no sense to me. It is Nimoy. Hey, Z. Yeah, this is the actual, they got the actual cast for this game. At least for the CD re-release, which the GOG version has. So yeah, it's Shatner, it's DeForest Kelly, it's Nimoy. Even the others. Uhura's here, Sulu, Scotty. They got everybody. It's great. Talk. No. You guys aren't... Well, you guys might be useful. I doubt it, but let's see.
Brother Chandray was.
Yeah, you're not useful right now. You're doing the same thing.
I headed up the party that's...
Can you tell us what they look like?
Yeah,
like
you've already told us.
Demons didn't follow?
No.
How about you?
I am Brother Griznash.
Captain, a croc...
It is.
No.
I believe this may be...
You got the same
you
thing.
You get no response.
Yeah, I can't... You can't talk to the door. Alright, let's see if the leader over here has... I wonder if I can go this way. First off, let's go talk to this guy. See if he has anything left to offer me.
I never dreamed that...
No, you don't have any new advice for me. Well, it was 92 or so. So... 92 or 93, I don't remember when Duen passed away. I think he's in this. I might have been mistaken, but I believe he was in the credits at the beginning. He certainly sounds like he's in it. It sounded like Scotty complaining about the engines. Let me just see if I can quickly double check something here. Yeah, Duhan is in this. He actually is. I just checked the manual for the credits. So... Might be the last thing he was in then, I wonder. It's okay, I have to do something with this panel. I have to figure out what this panel is used for. And I can't think of anything. Oh, he died in 2005. Then yeah, okay, that's... He might have done other things after this then. I might have to look this one up already. The first puzzle, actual puzzle I come across, and I can't figure it out. Because I can't click anything up here. But I mean, you know... Full. Oh, that's right, he did. Yeah, Doohan was in one of the episodes of TNG. Great episode, too. One of the best. I mean, after all, I think that was the Data Something Green episode. Same year, according to IMDb. More of the original, the Star Trek TOS cast is alive than Babylon 5's. That's kind of sad. Nothing works here. I am going to have to look this one up. Nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
Yes, nothing happens. Can't do anything with
this
panel.
There's nothing at the moment.
Until I figure this out. Well, first puzzle. There he goes, guys. The very first puzzle, and I am lost. This is amazing. Huh, apparently this game was on NES also. Really? Apparently, let's see if this answer actually works.
Welcome to our home. Thank you for repairing our somnambutron.
Stop. You're trespassing on Federation territory.
Kirk! Okay, that isn't what he actually said. I get the choice of saying that. But that is the worst fucking answer, Kirk. Are you kidding me? Clearly, they were here first. Also, yeah, apparently I had to set all of them to one notch. I don't know how you're supposed to figure that out from the thing above, but there you go. Oh, that is a lot of dead from that. Okay, let's see what else Kirk here has to say.
I welcome you on behalf of the United Federation of Planets. Who are you? Where you come from?
That would be the proper choice.
We did fix your machine. Can we write the repair bill off against rent on this land? Stop.
I do like that you really can make him an asshole, but I'm not going to.
Where you come from?
We call ourselves Nauians. Thousands of years ago, we saw that meteor impacts were going to cause an ice age. We created this huge underground shelter to preserve our race, keeping us in suspended animation until the planet had recovered. We programmed the machinery to revive us at the next eclipse, but we did not count on the destruction of our moon.
Some advanced civilization.
How do you even know that happened, then? If you guys have been slumbering for thousands of years, and I just flipped the switch, you just got revived from it, how do you know anything that's been happening? You guys ought to be freaking out. Who are you people? How did you get here? What happened to the moon? What, did Dragon Ball come by? No, they have the internet. Yes, thank you.
Perhaps you can tell us about the demons. Some advanced civilization. Perhaps you can tell us about the demons.
What are they gonna know? They've been asleep!
The demons, as you call them, are created by a machine designed to keep intruders away from our sleep chambers. It pulls from the minds of any approaching creature their most
feared enemy. Yeah, I kind of figured that's what it was gonna be.
And produces replicas to scare them away. For you and your crew, it was Klingons. For the Tellarite, a wolf demon. And for the other humans, a demon from their religion. On behalf of my people, thank you for waking us. I will turn off the machinery which creates our guardians, so that they no longer bedevil those with whom we now share our home. Oh, woe! Alas! The key is missing. I can do nothing.
Oh my God, that sounded like Charlie the Unicorn.
Guardians, unless the key can be found. I implore you, if you can help, please do so.
That sounded like Charlie the Unicorn.
Save new game. Replace previous.
So now I have to find a key. Where is the key going to be?
Have you found the key?
What am I looking for? Is the key on Candy Mountain?
The alien emerged from this metal chamber. This appears to control some unusual...
I guess I have to go back down and talk to the people, because I'm sure one of them has the key. All right, Doctor Who, we'll see you later. Enjoy sleeping in your TARDIS. Don't tell me you don't think that's where they got that inspiration from. We're just gonna leave the bodies here. Yeah, whatever.
I headed up the party that's...
Can you tell us what they looked like?
Like the demon...
The demons didn't...
No.
Okay, so you guys didn't... You didn't find anything. Did
Brother
you find
Candor
anything?
Was.
No, you didn't find anything. Did you find
I
anything?
Brother Grisnash.
No, you didn't find anything.
It is.
I believe this may...
So you guys didn't find anything. How about the other guy? Did he find anything? Come on, you have to have found something. You know what? It's going to be one of these, isn't it?
A glass-fronted display of mineral... Brother Stephen watches patiently as you examine...
I never dreamed that...
Okay, well, I'm going to have to scan these, because that metal one is probably it.
I read a collection of small items of no evident value. I would characterize this as a small museum display, Captain.
So this is the obvious place where the key is going to be, and there's no key. At least not that we can find.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Lend him a hand.
See how the fingertips have micro-sized sensors? I wonder what use they may have.
Opening the door. We already know that. You're not going to give us the key, are you? Is there a key over here? Do one of these guys have a key on them?
They look like Klingons. They look like
Klingons.
Yeah,
we know that. Looking for a key. Unless the hand is the key. Give him the hand, see if that works. Because there's nothing else out here that looks like a key. Go in there!
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
It's not the key. Okay.
This life form appears to be intelligent, a new sentient race. There appears to be a resemblance between it and the Solatus, although the present forms are quite small and definitely non-sentient.
Thank you, Spock.
This seems to be a cryogenic suspension chamber, Captain.
This appears to control some unusual security equipment.
Have you found the key?
Tell me what the key is! What am I looking for?
Fascinating. This life form may represent what would have happened had the dinosaurs of your Earth not become extinct.
Oh, they become praying mantises?
Perhaps we should try to communicate with the alien.
Welcome to 10 minutes ago, McCoy. The red shirt might have a better idea than you. Oh, fuck it.
This life form appears to be intelligent.
Ah! It's not what I was doing. Can I interact with this? No. Can I interact with
this?
There
is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Can I interact with the machine?
There is nothing at the moment. There is nothing at the moment for me to do. There is nothing at the moment for...
Many alien machines.
Yes, I know that. Where's the flipping key? Like, there's nowhere to go in this. There's like 5 screens. If there's only 5 screens, how come I can't find anything in them? I mean, there's nothing here that looks like any type of key. I can't go off to the sides. Nope. Can I go to the other side? Nope. Alright, let's get out of the cave. Nothing here but berries. Plants.
A Gondorian fern.
And a Gondorian fern.
Facadian moss grows on the cave wall. A Gondorian fern. Various types of berries grow amongst the bushes.
Okay, but no key.
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything.
Nothing happens equals, hey, listen. I like that. You fail to obtain anything. Not, there's nothing here to find. It's, you fail! Try harder!
The path is surrounded by some beautiful shrubbery.
You could obtain something if you tried harder.
Various bushes and shrubs grow along the edge of the forest.
All mining equipment use this road. Alright, well, it's time to check the boxes then, because I can't think of anything else. It's got to be in that display case! I mean, it's got the various objects. One of them is a metal object. Why can't we see what's in it?
Boxes of supplies and mining equipment litter the floor. Boxes of supplies and... Boxes of supplies...
Yes.
I detect various pieces of mining equipment, but nothing of note. I detect various pieces of mining...
So it's not in the boxes. You sure you guys don't have anything?
A grim-faced miner colonist nods curtly at you.
You'll understand if I don't stand up, I hope. I am not well.
The Tellarite appears completely at home, surrounded by humans. But the wrinkling on his brow indicates a great deal of worry.
And again, you guys don't have anything new to say.
I headed up the party that
you headed it up.
Like the demons,
they look like
the
demons.
No.
They didn't follow you because
you get no response.
Defending the area.
I am Brother Grisnash.
Yeah.
It is.
I believe this may be significant.
Yes, we know, because we've already figured that
Brother
out.
Kendre was.
So you guys have no... What happened to the guy I saved? Is that him? I suppose it could be him. And you're sure there's nothing in here that would be helpful?
A multi-purpose workspace with fine assorted pieces of glass. An antiquated molecular... A glass-fronted display. An old-fashioned computer. Brother Stephen watches.
I never dreamed.
You get no response.
Yes,
you get no response.
Try talking to the rock.
You get no response.
That didn't work.
You get no response.
But just.
The glass case is locked.
Of course it's locked. Why wouldn't it be locked?
You fail to obtain anything.
You fail!
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything.
Can I take the disk out of the computer, maybe?
You fail to obtain anything.
But the display case is locked. Can we talk to you?
I never...
No, we can't talk to you. Can I shoot the damn display case?
Save new game. Replace...
Jim, that would destroy the glass case.
That's the point! Yes!
Jim, that would destroy the glass case.
You're very observant, Doctor.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. The mechanism in the hand has already been repaired. Nothing happens.
I read a collection of small items of no evident value. I would characterize this as a small museum display, Captain.
If it's me... If anyone has found anything and taken the key away, it would be here.
Nothing to report, Captain. Fascinating, Captain. It is an up... A vintage 82...
Yeah.
The residue of several different compounds are in... Nothing to report, Captain.
I got nothing. So we've hit the second puzzle of the game, and I still can't figure anything out. But it's like 1, 2, 3... Four. Five. Six, seven screens. There are seven screens on this map, and I cannot find something on any of them. Unless there's a hidden eighth screen somewhere, get through the damn door, Kirk. Tell me what the key is.
Have you found the key?
What is the key? Okay, can I talk to myself?
I think we found the answer to our mystery.
Okay, Red Shirt, what do you have to say?
What is that?
There's a reason you're a Red Shirt. I've already used the machine, so it does no good.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Because I don't have a key.
There is nothing at the moment
for
me to do there.
Can I get inside the pod? Is the key inside the pod, maybe? Go in the pod. Go in the pod. Don't go behind the pod. Oh, I can just walk right through it. Woo! I can phase through matter. Look at that. Can I phase through the dude? I wonder. Yep, I can phase right through this guy. I don't think he really exists. Look at that. This game is just showing us that he's a hologram and we shouldn't listen to him. And here I go again. I am fail. Da-da-da. So there's supposedly a key that I could have gotten already. It isn't a fucking display case. It's exactly the thing I thought it was. The piece of twisted metal. But apparently, the case is supposed to open. See, now that's frustrating. Because I knew what the answer was. I even used the case. Oh, the case is locked. What?! Use. Case.
You are interested in my little museum of curiosity?
Now you've changed it!
Looks like a pile of junk if you ask me. Yes, tell us about these things. Where did you find all this? Looks like a pile of junk. Yes, tell us about these things.
I enjoy talking about these treasures.
Of course you do.
Shall I go into mineral specimens? Meteorite, fossil shells, skull of a small alien animal, twist of metal. This chunk of rock is a greatly weathered example of a vanadium tungsten alloy, which doesn't occur naturally. It is my best evidence that the area was previously inhabited. Shall I go into mineral specimen?
But you see, there you go. This is one of those things where I tried doing that. Oh, it's locked. Well, what's the point then? Am I going to have to do everything? So we ran into another game earlier that did the same type of thing to me, where I had the right answer, but you had to do it twice in order for it to work. Well, what the hell? Why make it do it twice? Because that just tells the player that it's wrong, like everything else you've tried, it's wrong. Hate.
True curiosities, nothing more. I think they're very pretty, don't you? Shall I go into mineral specimens? Meteorite. I believe this is evidence of the cataclysm which destroyed the moon of Pollux V eons past. I've constructed a theoretical model based on analysis of the planet's rings of what things might have been like. I think that the moon, like Earth's moon, would have made a total eclipse of the sun possible. I would have liked to have seen that. For conditions making a perfect total eclipse are rare in the universe. Our God creates great wonders.
Hello again, V8.
Mineral specimen. Meteorite.
Yes, great,
fossil
great
shells.
Design. Great
One of
design.
The oldest forms I've seen on this planet. Our God makes beautiful things indeed. Shall I go into mineral specimen? Or would you rather twist a skull of a small skull of a modern Silati, the largest creature native to this planet? Yeah, about the size of a house cat from Earth. The Silatis combine a rather insectoid pattern with four-legged reptilian form, including praying mantis-like forelimbs.
Oh, so I was right with that
Shall
description.
Shall I go into...
I guess I didn't have to go into all of them. I could have just gone to...
Or would you rather move on to something else? Very well. I can't imagine why, but if you have a further interest in any of this, take what you like. But please remember to return my treasures when you're done with them.
Okay, so now he's going to let me take it. So grab... the metal bit. Piece of twisted metal. I'll leave the rest, because I don't think the rest is any importance whatsoever. Let's get the heck out of here. I am 0 for 2 for puzzles for this game. You can see why I don't play these very often. Oh, they. Well, let's have some fun. Let's play some Star Trek. And I have more of these games. Again, currently available. This is on GOG. It's on Steam. Last time there was a summer sale on GOG, it actually did have this whole Star Trek set, which I purchased. So, if you're interested, if you want to play this, and you think you can do better than me, that wouldn't be difficult. Pick it up. It's worth a try.
You found the key. I can now turn off the machinery creating our guardians, and no more sentience shall be at risk. Surely the Holy One smiles upon us all.
Oh, great, more religious people.
Captain, but please carry this request from my people to yours. We have much ancient knowledge we can share, and we would like to join your Federation. Go in peace.
How?
I will be glad to accept your application to the Federation. We shall have a diplomatic envoy sent to make the final arrangements.
We look forward to meeting them. We also look forward to having discourse with the colonists. Farewell. May the Holy One bless you.
Live long and prosper.
You can't see Kirk how Enterprise. Defeated I
Name
am
us
right
up,
now.
Mr. Scott.
You can't see just how absolutely defeated I am right now. Why would you even know about the Federation? You just woke up!
Message from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have read your report on the problems at Pollux 5 and evaluate your performance at 97%. You and your crew received 3 commendation points. The top brass at Starfleet are impressed. Outstanding work, Jim.
I might have known there weren't any demons.
We all have demons of our own, Bones. The ones we can't confront are often the hardest to deal with.
These demons were based on fear, Captain. A human failing.
I don't know, Spock. Everything that I've ever read about demons describes them as having pointy ears. Hi, Jack.
Hi, Jack. How are you?
Message from Starfleet, Captain.
On screen, Lieutenant.
The USS Enterprise is to report immediately to Beta Myonid. The USS Masada has failed to report as scheduled. Determine nature of delay and take whatever measures are necessary.
Set course for Beta Myonid, sir.
All right, let's save the game again.
Save new game. Replace previous game.
Okay, gotta alt-tab out to look at my map. It's on the instruction manual. I'm looking for, what was it, Beta something? Beta Madrid, okay. Mimid. It's going to be... Okay, the map's not up yet. Hit N for navigation! This one, I think. Let me just double-check my map again. Yeah, that's that one. Let's go! Episode 2, Hijacked.
There is an unidentified ship closing rapidly. Weapons on and shields up.
Raising shields.
Arming weapons.
Message coming in, sir.
On screen, Lieutenant.
Leave the Beta Myonid system immediately. You're interfering in Lossy affairs.
We are conducting a search and rescue mission for the USS Masada. It was last reported in this system. We cannot leave until we can confirm its location and condition.
So be it. You have been warned. Prepare to die.
Space battle time! I hit V to go to full screen like this. Of course, I have to be able to find where these guys are. There we are. I'm bad at space battles. Gotta try to lead him. Ah, he swung around.
Ah!
Okay, space battles are gonna be a pain in this game. Where are you? Where did you go? There you are. Are you gonna swing around and hit me, are you? No. There you go. That hit me. I guess weapons are only phasers here. Oh, there's the planet. Oh, getting shot at. Where are you that you're shooting at me? Where are you? See, the radar only shows me where the planet is. As far as I know. Hitting V also resets. There he goes. Resets it to the... Oh, nailed him! You know, I should be running into him like that, too, but hitting V... Yeah, see, that just shows me where the planet is. I don't think it's actually showing me that radar down there. And the radar, 2D radar, doesn't really help in a 3D space anyway. Here we go. I was thinking it's stupid that these stars are flying past me. And hello, it's a star. It should be way off. The stars honestly shouldn't be moving on their own. Even flying like this, those stars should be absolutely still. They are too far away to be moving, especially when I'm not at warp speed. I am at impulse in combat right now. Yeah, I'm gonna bitch about that. But it looks better. But it's not realistic. And someone is going to point out that I'm hearing phasers in space.
Yeah,
nothing's realistic. God. He's swinging around to hit me again. Here he goes. I don't think I'm doing very well. Oh, there he is again. I think I'm on him now. Now he's trying to get far enough away.
I don't know how long she can take it, Captain.
I tried to hit E to go faster. I don't know if it works or not. Come on. I don't know how far away they are. This guy is, so I don't know how hard to lead him. Oh, he's coming toward me now. Yep, I took some damage. I took a lot of damage. Scotty?
Lowering shields, Captain.
No, no, I'm not right.
Raising shields.
Repair? No, repair didn't work. Okay, D. D for damage. Let's repair the shields.
Aye, sir.
Let's go back to the view. Not the show. Let's go back to the full screen map. So I've got Scotty trying to repair my shields. I don't know if I'm actually hurting this guy or not. I mean, it looks like I should be. But I can't tell if he's hurt or what. I'm supposed to try analyzing him next time I see him. And you turn so slowly!
Target analysis of...
Okay, I am hurting him. Because he's got shield, his side and low is weak, apparently. Not his front, though. That's where I really want to hurt him. Yep, there he went. Ugh. I look at myself
target
again.
Analysis off.
Yeah, okay. I'm doing better than he is, at least.
Target analysis off.
So I can compare my shields to his. But only one at a time. And if I do this, I can't see either one. So I can either have most of my screen taken up so I can see damage, or I can have no GUI whatsoever and actually be able to combat. It looks like my shields have been repaired a fair amount. I can't tell if he's hitting me or not.
Target analysis off.
Oh yeah, he was hitting me. Damage. Repair the engines. Engines.
I shot him.
Ow! God, I'm getting hurt! The engine's been repaired. Let's repair the hull.
I saw it.
Engines are hurt again. Let's repair those.
I saw it.
My shields are getting hurt, and the hull's damaged again, so let's repair that.
I saw it.
I am amazing at the space battle. Get off me! Get off of me! Hell are you? My boots. Let's do that.
Aye, sir.
Because I don't know what else is damaged right now. Something's damaged. Weapons, maybe? Get off of me! Where are you? Engines and hull damage. That's not good. I'm not doing anything to you, am I? No, you're doing fine. Damn it. I am losing. Oh! Get off me! Engines. Repair the engines, Scott. Okay, repair the weapons!
Aye, sir.
Where is he?
Phasers repaired, Captain.
Engines.
Aye, sir.
Saw you. Weapons need repair now.
Aye, sir. Phasers repaired, Captain.
What else needs it? Deflector's hurting. Oh, I have photon torpedoes if I right-click. Repair the hull.
Aye, sir. Bridge repaired, Captain.
The bridge I'm worried about, dude. Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? God, look at all the damage I'm taking. It's terrible. You are repairing the hull, right?
Aye, sir.
Oh. I need to repair my weapon systems, apparently.
The ship's initial intercept course was from the last known position of the Masada. I suggest we orbit the planet for a closer sensor scan, sir.
Yeah, I actually skipped one of those. I did not mean to. But I'm actually going to, before I do any scouting, I'm going to repair my ship.
Aye, sir.
Probably don't need to. It's probably automatic at this point. Where's the planet? Oh, that dot down there wasn't the planet, it was the ship. Well, hell. Planet, where are you? I know you're at your sum. I just probably push O and it would take me there. Okay, let's repair the shields.
Aye, sir.
There it is. Alright, let's save, since I actually did manage to do something.
Save new game. Replace previous game.
I am bad at space combat. Let's orbit the planet! Yay! The hell?
There she is, Captain. She does not appear to be seriously damaged. Her shields are up, and 27 life forms are aboard.
Hailing frequencies.
Hailing the ship, Captain.
Greetings, Federation Imperialists. I am Elasi Seren, and I have claimed this ship as a blow for freedom against Federation tyranny.
This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. You are illegally in possession of Starfleet property. This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. Listen, Elasi. Hand over the ship and hostages now, or things are going to get very nasty. This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. Mr. Elasi, it appears that you have found something the Starfleet lost. This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS. This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise.
There's a couple ways I could do this one. I'm not going to do the threatening
thing. You have found something the Starfleet lost.
As much as I kind of like this choice, I'm just going to do...
This is Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise.
You don't know. Let's be the, quote, diplomatic version.
Mr. Elasi, it appears...
You're not illegal in possession. You found this. Why, thank you for finding it to us. We will gladly take it back off your hands now. Thank you very much.
Good, Captain. You have a sense of humor. That will make this much easier. Ah, the infamous Captain Kirk. The Masada is mine. You will release 25 political prisoners I specify, or I will destroy the ship and its crew. The list of those wrongfully imprisoned should be coming over to you now.
Data file captured, Captain. Computer indicates they were all convicted of piracy with various counts of murder and mayhem thrown in.
Freeing the prisoners you requested will take time. We have to track down their current locations, and Starfleet will have to grant permission to move them here. I will get that started. You should tender a show of good faith on your part. Will you beam over so we can discuss negotiations face to face? We can work together on this, Elassi. How about beaming some of the hostages over as a show of good faith? Freeing the prisoners you requested
okay,
will take
time. Okay, so do
time.
I want some of the hostages, or do I want to try to get him
and Starfleet will have to grab
this is probably
to
not
going to
work,
we
so...
We can work together on this, Elassi. How about beaming some of the hostages over as a show of good faith?
Because he's not going to fall for the other one. He'd be very stupid to beam himself over. Let's try to get him to beam some of the hostages at least.
What? Lower my shield so you can beam over a war party? I'm not stupid, Captain. We'll play by my rules.
See, either way, we're going to probably have
to. The shields are up, Captain. Our hands are tied.
The Enterprise can overpower the Masada and take her, but the pirates would have all the time they need to kill every one of the hostages.
Will you send over data on the whereabouts and conditions of my falsely accused clansmen languishing in your dungeons, Captain?
Very well, we'll do it your way. I will put together the data packet. Kirk out. Your fellow Elassi have been tried in Federation courts of law and found guilty of their crimes. We'll listen to your complaints if you discuss them reasonably. Forget it, Elassi Sereth. You'll be the next one languishing on a Federation penal planet unless you drop your shields and surrender to me immediately. Very well, with your fellow
Elassi
have been tried in Federation courts of law and found guilty
of their crimes. Diplomatic.
We'll listen to your complaints if you discuss them reasonably.
We're not letting them go. They were convicted.
These hostages are being tried by the Elassi justice system. You have the final say, Captain, whether they receive the death penalty or not. Elassi Sereth out.
Save new game. Replace previous...
Can I contact Starfleet? Is there a button for that? Communications?
Elassi Prime, a binary star system which one inhabited planet, Manalvagorn, is currently undergoing a revolution between factions which survive from raiding Federation ships and factions that wish to make peace.
This is a shame
the
they didn't get the proper computer voice.
Several continents were colonized centuries ago by the Andorian. The self-determination of the Manalvagorians and the treatment of minority Andorians is an issue of considerable controversy. The Elassi clan is the largest clan of pirates and have been blamed for 46 attacks on Federation ships in the last 3 years. They use revolutionary zeal to mask their activities as pirates. Starfleet tactical analysis characterized them as being daring and impulsive, but skilled in analysis and planning. In effect, they are very capable of acting in an unorthodox and surprising manner when their plans begin to fall apart. They are considered a Class 1 threat to the Federation.
Class 1 threat. I hope that means minor threat, because these guys really can't do that much to the Federation as a whole. But that's cool that the computer actually gives you information like that. If you press C, it brings up the computer. You can find information on what you're looking for. Did it help me? No. But it was information. What else we got here?
Elassi pirates.
Hey!
There are several bands of pirates based from Elassi Prime. The Ajalasi family, the Ajthuri, and the Ambrasili. Recent events on Manalvagor have caused these bands, which typically battle each other, to unite and prey on Federation ships. Ajalasi, meaning the Fist of Elassi, a name taken by the Demiri pirate clan of Manalvagor, and used as their surname for nearly 70 years. Elassi, meaning the Fist of Elassi.
Okay, what do we got here?
There are several bands of pirates based from Elassi Prime. The Ajalasi family, the Ajthuri, and the Ambrasili. Recent events on Manalvagor have
A-J-T-H-U-R-I.
Topic not available, Captain. topic not available, Captain.
Ilasi Prime. Ilasi Angelasi.
Meaning did I misspell that? Ilasi. Ilasi A-J-T-H-U-R-I.
Pirates based from Ilasi Prime.
Topic not available, Captain.
So that one's not available.
Serious.
That's not what I was looking for either. Can I beam down to the planet's surface? I have to lower my shields to do that and they'd notice. Let's try it.
Save new game. Replace previous game.
Okay, shields.
Lorne shields, Captain.
Transport.
Captain, the Masada's shields are still up.
No, I want to transport down to the planet.
Raising shields.
And I can't click anyone. I'd have to do it myself.
May I respectfully remind the Captain that we haven't accomplished our mission, sir.
That was pressing O again, so we're not done here. We can't really leave. Spock?
Lowering shields,
no.
Captain. Raising shields. Target analysis on.
Yeah, the analysis doesn't do me any good. All these buttons
do.
You
can't take it, Captain.
I think E just has Scotty tell us how much trouble he's in. Can I hail Starfleet? Is there a button for that? Well, what happens if
shields
I press H?
Return, Captain.
Yay, the shields are back. Well, in that case, let's prepare everything else, dude.
Aye, sir. Phasers repaired, Captain. Aye, sir. Torpedoes repaired, Captain. Aye, sir. Sensors repaired, Captain.
I think everything actually is repaired now.
Aye,
so.
Sir.
Also,
Captain.
That wasn't sensors. That's a deflector dish.
Aye, sir.
I'm a nerd. What can I say? Okay, well, let's try hailing again, see what happens.
Hailing the ship, Captain.
Do you have the data packet, Kirk?
Not yet. We are still working on it.
Captain, there is now one fewer life form on the Masada.
Pirates. Ships that prey on other ships are, unfortunately, still common in the Federation. Since the Babel Peace Conference, most pirate attacks have come from the Ilasi clan, based somewhere near Ilasi Prime. See Ilasi Prime for details.
Yeah, that's the ship pirates. I'm here to look for.
There are several bands of pirates based from Ilasi.
Yeah, I already know that already.
The Ajalasi family.
Topic not available. Topic not available.
Trying to hail,
Captain.
Trying to hail got someone killed. It's the computer.
May I respectfully remind the Captain that we haven't accomplished our mission, sir.
And navigate doesn't do anything.
Disarming weapons. Arming weapons.
Ah! I can't shoot them! Won't let me just straight up shoot them dudes, either.
Target analysis off. Target analysis off.
How am I supposed to get the information?
Captain, we could use the command prefix code to lower the Masada's shields briefly, long enough for one transporter burst. Captain, we could use the command prefix
Masada.
Code to lower the Masada's shields briefly.
Masada, USS, a Federation tug tender, registry NCC 293391. Currently under the command of Captain Kevin Keeler. Crew complement of 17. Primary mission, tow, repair of disabled ships. Its input override code is 2933.
See, that sounds like something that should not be kept on computers like this.
736 like, dash 3829.
I should have to request. Oh. What's the point of an override code if you don't have access to it? I mean, you can't really request Starfleet to give you the override code because transmission could be intercepted or something. If you have it on the computer banks, it could get read that way. Override codes are problematic. Let's just say that. Did you not see The Wrath of Khan? I have, but it's been a long time. Okay,
Captain, we could use the command prefix code to lower the Masada's shield.
Well, let's do that. Oh, I have to write this down myself?
That code had no effect.
Masada.
I have to write this down myself.
A Federation tug tender, registry NCC-29.
Oh yeah, I don't doubt that they've used this override code on the show before, or in this case in the movies. It's just, the very concept of it is problematic. Why would they have this? Why would they have it on their computers that someone else could access it? It just seems like if you had control of one Enterprise, or you know, one Federation ship, which they do, how come they can't look up my override code and do the same thing to me? What? No, computer, I was trying to write that down.
Masada, USS. A Federation tug tender. Registry NCC-29.
But it's like, they have access to a computer on that ship.
Currently under the command.
In theory, they should have access to the Enterprise's override code. So if I can look it up on my computer and do this, why can't they do the same thing to me? Now you see the problem I have with something like this. Hail, send a prefix code.
That code had no effect, Captain.
I wasn't done typing it in. I was using the number pad, and it probably didn't like that, did it?
Sending prefix and lowering the Masada's shields.
Lowering shields, Captain.
Spock, come with me. Mr. Scott, you have the comm.
Now, we did unfortunately already lose one of the crew members over here.
Replace delete previous.
That's okay. I'm not going for perfection. I'm just going for beating it. You believe it requires a clearance code to access? Well, that's possible, but you know what's to stop them from getting it.
This man was obviously the transporter engineer. He is unconscious, but alive.
He's got a red shirt on. Let's try to heal him. I mean, we are the doctors here. Well, the doctor's with us anyway. Not that doctor. Damn it, Jim! I'm a doctor, not a doc. Oh, right.
I can revive it.
What did you say?
He's not hurt badly. I can revive him.
You can revive him. Okay.
Thank you, Doctor. Be careful, Captain. The Alassi like to set booby traps. If you need any equipment, I've got my tools in this workspace.
That was a pretty poor line read, man. That was a really poor line read. Okay, let's take a look at what we just picked up.
The Runcinate Transmogrifier. This device was invented by an engineer with a sense of humor about names. With the proper attachments, engineers use it for temporary fixes on key circuits.
Okay, let's take a look and see.
The transporter bay has been damaged in a recent firefight.
Clearly.
The transporter bay has been damaged.
It's gonna be for everything you're gonna say, Arya. I'm trying to look at the individual panels.
A small bomb appears to have damaged the transporter controls.
See, now that's actually information I could use. Can I scan these things?
Even our most efficient chief engineer Scott would have trouble repairing this damage in less than 2 days.
Their transporter's hosed.
I am registering energy residue from phaser fire and phaser grenade detonations.
Phaser grenades.
Of another energy weapon, but the type is unknown.
Lovely. Okay, well, let's try moving on now. We finally made a little bit of progress.
Previous game.
See how I get killed coming up here.
Twisted debris has been scattered along the side of the corridor. You are in a typical starship corridor. A tangle of mangled equipment reduced to junk. There are the remains of 5 phasers without power packs, a drained phaser welder, and scraps of wire and uncertain bits of metal junk. This view screen communication terminal has been damaged beyond repair.
It looks fine, but it's been damaged beyond repair. Now, before I go walking down this hall, I just want to make sure that the junk on the side here is just junk and not an IED.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Okay.
5 phasers without power packs, a drained phaser welder, insulation and bits of wire, and droplets of cooled molten metal.
Nothing useful, in other words.
Strong electromagnetic readings come from the doorway at the far end of the hallway.
Okay, well, let's take a look at that doorway.
Some kind of force field appears to cover the door.
Of course it does. How about over here?
You are in a typical starship.
I mean, it looks like there's another door on the side here. Let's go through it. Use! Phasers!
Hey, what are you doing here?
Captain, if we could manage to overload the force field, it would probably detonate the bomb before we could rescue the crewmen.
Well, I got those two down.
You are in the brig of the Masada. 9 of the crew members are held in the cell. 2 Alasi guards lie on the floor.
Alive, of course, because I just stunned them.
This guard is stunned. This guard is stunned. You are in the brig of the Masada. 9 of the crew
members. I know that. Thank you.
This appears to be the button that turns the brig force field on and off.
And I'm betting if you push it, the bomb goes off. What do you bet?
Save new, replace previous.
Okay, let's get a good look at that bomb here.
A bomb located just inside the force field.
Inside the force field, of course. Which is actually where you'd want to place it. That way the bomb goes off, it kills everyone inside, and you're fine. I bet if I push it, it'll go off. So let's scan before I push it.
Captain, the switch has been booby-trapped to detonate a bomb. Presumably inside the brig somewhere.
Yeah, right there.
A medium-strength phaser bomb. The brig force field would contain the explosion, but it would kill the crew members within the cell. I recommend that we find a way of disarming it, Captain.
Yeah, see? So, how about if we do this to it?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Nothing. Okay. Can we talk to the guys inside, I wonder?
The crew is tired and has elevated signs from extreme stress, but they will survive.
Will they, Doctor? If I push this button, they won't. You can't talk to him, so.
You are in the brig of.
How do I disarm this bomb without killing everyone inside?
You are in the brig of the. This appears to be the button that turns the. Nothing happens.
Can't do anything to that.
Nothing happens.
Can't do anything to that. I can scan it, but it doesn't tell me what to
use. Captain, the switch has been booby-trapped to detonate a bomb.
Yeah, okay.
Save new game. Replace previous...
Now, I'm going to assume that if I use the panel, it's going to bring up the panel and not just make the bomb explode. But I saved the game just in case using the panel means I press the button, the bomb explodes. Let's find out. Yep.
You set off some type of booby trap. The force...
I just wanted to see if I would, you know, give me a close-up of the panel to interact with, because out here, nothing happens. So... Can I mess with the wires?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Like, I have this tool here! It doesn't have any attachments.
The Runcinate transmogrifier. This device was in...
I don't have any attachments. That might be why. Can I get the panel? It's gonna make that explode now? Yeah, I made it explode.
You set off some type of boot.
So tried taking the wires off of it, and that made it explode too.
You fail to obtain anything.
You fail!
You fail to obtain any...
Can I get the bomb?
You can't. It is located just inside the force field.
Yerp. Okay, use... Can I use the wires? Can I use this on the wires? No, because it made it explode, remember?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Can I scan just the wires?
Captain, the switch has been booby-trapped.
No.
A medium-strength phaser bomb.
No. What if I go back and talk to the engineer, then? I mean, he ought to know. Whoa. He ought to know stuff, right? Talk.
I suppose I should be grateful to see anyone after that. I thought I was dead.
Well, with any luck, you won't have to...
Provided the Alassi don't have anything to say about it.
You get no
response. Yeah, I accidentally cut off that line. Whatever. Okay, so that's not going to help me. He can't come in... Walk, thank you. He can't get up and come help me disarm the bomb, even though he's an engineer. Is there anything over here I can pick up? Yes, I picked up wires. And parts. Oh, sweet. Let's see what we got here. Look. What do we have?
Some scraps of metal found in the corridors of the Masada.
Scraps of metal?
Some scraps of wire found in the corridors of the Masada.
Scraps of... Wire?
A phaser welder. It is without power. These weapons are powerless, having been shorn of their power packs.
So if I can find power packs, I could do something.
Twisted debris has been scattered along the side of the corridor. You are in a...
Also, you notice the pointer's flipping
corridor.
You off, kind of?
You are in a typical starship corridor. You are in a typical...
Okay. There's a force field over there. That doesn't do us any good.
You are in a typical starship...
There's just debris on the side. I can't pick up the debris.
You fail to obtain anything.
You fail! Alright, so I'm gonna have to use the parts that I just got... Oh, whoa, 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 hello, you guys are back up, huh?
Hey, what are you doing here?
Do I have to kill them to keep them from popping up like that? I don't want to kill them, I mean, I'm Starfleet.
Save new game, replace pre-
Okay. So, let's try using the tool. I can't use them on the things, can I? Let's...
Nothing happens.
Figure out what to use over
Nothing
here.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
How do I combine things?
Nothing happens.
Because, I mean, I've got a tool, right? but I don't think I can combine anything. It's not letting me. Oh, right click. What the hell? What's that? Oh, it's a use button. Right click takes me back a screen. It's the same as hitting escape.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
I'm not trying to. I'm trying to do this. Use it on the bomb. Nothing happens. On the wires. Nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
Hey, listen. This has no power, so it's not going to do any good.
Nothing happens.
I don't see any way to combine things, because as soon as you click, you can't click and drag. So as soon as you click, you're done.
Nothing happens.
Alright, let's go back to the engineer and see if he can do anything with these parts that I have. After all, he's the engineer, right?
Nothing happens.
Yo, engineer dude.
Nothing happens.
Machine guy McRedshirt, do something.
Nothing happens.
He can't do crap. Talk to him.
I suppose I should be grateful to see anyone after that.
Well, with any luck, you won't.
Provided the Alassian.
Kuman Simpson.
Oh, he has a name!
The cabinet is empty. The transporter bay has been damaged in a recent firefight. The transporter bay. A small bomb appears to have damaged. The transporter bay has.
Captain, I need to find a bit that will fit into the transmogrifier before I can go further with this.
What kind of bit? I mean, we've got scraps.
Nothing happens.
Got wires. I'm wondering if this is supposed to go in it.
Nothing happens.
Because the tool itself has the power.
Nothing happens.
Captain, I need to find a bit.
So this is like having a ratchet driver with no attachments, apparently.
The transporter bay.
Doesn't look like there's anywhere else to go. And if I walk back into that room, those two guys are going to be up again. What do you bet? Well, let's walk down the end of the corridor and get zapped by a shield. Yep, because I can't go through there. So there's three whole screens I can go to.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Now I don't have to worry about them anymore. Do I like doing that? No. Is there a combine feature? There's an I button brings up the inventory. Okay, well, let's take a look at this. There's a hat on the ground.
Only the red beret of the Alassi guard remains.
Yeah, because I got...
This door leads back...
Thank you. I got tired of them constantly coming back.
You are in the brig of the Masada. Nine of the crew members are held in the cell. The berets of two dead Alassi guards litter the floor.
Now, you see, if I could have figured out how to open the cell with these two being stunned, I would have done that and let these guys out, put the other guys in. But, of course, nothing's happening. Can I shoot
one Starfleet regulation phaser type 1, set to stun.
Won't let me shoot the... panel.
Captain,
even.
If we could manage to overload the force field, it would probably detonate the bomb.
Yeah, can't overload that. I can't do anything with that.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
There does not appear to be anything I can do. Again, third fucking puzzle in a row. I can't figure out what the answer is. I can't seem to combine anything in my inventory. I can't find anything else on the ground. I've talked to the only person there is to talk to. I am doing absolutely terrible at this game. There's nothing for me to look at. There's a bomb here. Great. There's wires down here. Great.
These wires look like a modification of some sort.
I know that, and I know what the wires do, but it won't tell me how to treat
Captain,
the wires.
The switch has been booby-trapped to detonate a... Captain, the switch has...
Yes, I know that. And as soon as I pick those wires up, they get killed.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
And it keeps moving my mouse cursor around.
Nothing happens.
See? It jumps up to the top there, but then it jumps right back down when it's done.
Nothing happens.
Okay, well that's not useful. There's gotta be something else out here that I'm missing. Like, there's debris
Twisted
on the ground.
Debris has been scattered along the side of the corridor.
But it's useless debris. It's nothing that's actually there. There's this panel
this
here.
This screen communication terminal has been damaged beyond repair.
Well, let's take a closer look at it. Can I
Nothing
take anything from
report,
it?
Captain.
No, I can't do that. Can I open it up with one
nothing
of the things?
Happens.
No, nothing happens. Hello, Navi. Hey,
nothing
listen.
Happens.
Hey, listen. Hey, listen.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
And this is why I hate point-and-click
Nothing
adventure
happens.
Games, because I haven't found the right thing to click the right order yet. There's nothing over
you
here.
You fail to obtain anything.
You fail to obtain
you
anything.
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything.
I don't think you should be moved, Jim.
Yeah, B8 says he thinks this looks like a pretty bad point-and-click adventure. The problem is, this...
You fail to obtain anything.
Most point-and-click adventures are this, right here. The only real difference is, in some of them, you can combine things in your inventory. But it's like, okay, look, there are three screens.
You fail to obtain
There are
anything.
Only three screens. I have clicked on everything there is to click on. Because the cursor highlights if there's anything to click on.
A small bomb appears to have damaged...
I have looked. I have scanned. Can I talk to my... What do
when
you have to say?
When this operation is complete, Captain, we should have Mr. Scott or Transporter
That's not useful.
Chief Khan come here to assist with the repairs.
Let's not look too far ahead, Mr. Spock.
Well, Jim, there's one thing I can tell you. I don't like Alassi.
I can't see them winning any popularity contests, Bones.
They can forget about my vote.
See, you guys aren't even giving me tips or anything. You're just...
This is just like their raid on Damocles Station. Hard, fast, and dirty.
Get what you can from this area. Let's get moving.
Captain, a thorough analysis is required.
Okay, but let's not stay too long in one place.
I'd love that, Captain. Unfortunately, I can't move ahead. There's nothing for me to talk to. There's nothing for me... The only thing to interact with is this. Like, okay. There's this...
A small bomb...
Okay, there's the panel here. It's damaged. I can't do anything because I don't have the right attachment for the tool.
Cool,
you're
Ryan
here,
Simpson.
But you can't do anything. You've already given me the only help you can, which is to open this panel.
The cabinet
the panel
is
that's
empty.
Opened now, and I've taken everything from it. There's nothing else in this room... I mean, here I am doing the pixel hunt. Is there anything that changes my icon? Nothing.
This is the main transporter pad of the Masada.
Okay, that's something new. Let's scan the main transporter pad.
Nothing to report, Captain.
There's nothing there. Can I grab anything from the main transporter
pad? You fail to obtain anything.
No, I can't. Can I use any of these nice new tools that I got, or scrap or anything on it? Nothing happens. This is point-and-click adventure games for you right here.
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. Every point-and-click adventure game in existence is just this. Try every possible freaking combination until something works.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Because a lot of these don't even make any logical sense. Okay, so the transporter pad, it's something I can interact with. Can't do anything with it right now. So this room is a big walk of nothing.
These
How about this?
These doors have been scarred by phaser fire. There was a battle here.
Yes, we know that. The good ones give clues. They all technically give clues. This is most of the time the clues are as obscure as the damn puzzle.
This view screen communication terminal has been damaged beyond repair.
And even
debris has been scattered along the side of the corridor.
Even some of the other ones, like if you want to play one of the better point and click adventure games, I Have No Mouth and I Must Scream. Again, it's available on Steam. I highly recommend it. I hate that game. I've solved most of the character's stuff in it, but it's again the same type of case where you're just running around poking stuff. And that is one of the better examples, but I can't get anything in it.
Scattered along the side of the corridor.
And what's really nice, if you actually got the physical copy of that one, it came with a really nice mouse pad. And if you buy it off of Steam, you actually do get the
Twisted Debris has been
short story that inspired it, which is more for adults. Wouldn't let your kid read it. But okay, there. Again, in this room, I have looked at everything.
Some kind of force field appears to cover the door.
There's a force field that covers the door. Great. Can I interact with it? Can I scan it?
A force field of unusual configurations has been erected in front of the doorway, which leads into the bridge. I don't think it would be healthy to approach too closely, Captain.
Thank you. That was all the information I have on it.
Tricorder readings indicate an indeterminate number of people in the brig. At least two are armed with phasers. I recommend caution when entering.
Except there aren't the people with phasers anymore. We killed them. Let's pick up the damn berets.
You fail to obtain anything.
I can't even pick up the hat.
You fail to obtain anything.
Can I scan the hat? You know you're in trouble in a game like this when your words are, "Can I scan the hat?"
Nothing to report, Captain.
No, I can't. Is there anything else in this room? There is the brig. There is the bomb. The panel. The wires. The two hats from the dead guards, because I got tired of them coming back every time I came back out of the room. And that's it. I've interacted with everything I can interact with, in every way I can think of to interact with. The only thing I haven't done...
The crew is tired and has a...
I have not tried talking to the bomb.
You get no response. You get no response. You get no response. You get no response.
The hat does not talk back. And I go over here and I try to pick the wires up. Bomb blows up.
You set off some type of booby trap. You fail to obtain any...
Yes, they're all dead. I don't even care anymore.
There is nothing at the moment from... There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
They're all dead. Whatever. I have to reload this game anyway! Can I go tell your friend that your friends are dead? Hi, all of your friends are dead because you're a lazy bastard.
I suppose I should be grateful to...
Well, with any...
Provided the...
And see, even that! I've killed everyone in the brig! So what? It didn't help me! Did I even get the wires from it? Yes.
A length of wire removed from the terrorist.
Okay, I got the wire.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
The wire doesn't do anything. But I have the wire. And look, the terrorist bomb is back.
You can't. It is located just...
How? How is the bomb still there? It detonated and killed everyone.
There is nothing at the moment.
You can't. It is located just...
But I pushed the button to open the force field!
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Oh, for three. I can't figure any damn thing out in this game.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Ah!
You are in a typical starship corridor.
There's nothing even left to pick up. Look.
You get no response.
Yeah, I was trying to talk to
you
him.
You fail to obtain anything.
Fail to obtain.
You fail to obtain anything.
Fail
to obtain anything.
There's nothing left to pick up anywhere.
You fail to obtain anything.
I don't know how to combine items in my inventory. The only thing I can think of is that's what you're supposed to do. That's all that's left, really, to do. Is try to combine items in my inventory. But I don't know how. Okay, I've got this item. Can I use it on something in my inventory? No, I can't even scan anything in my inventory. All I can do is look at things
the
in my inventory.
Make transmogrif- you are in a typical star-
I'm calling it right now. I am too frustrated to continue. It's already been a couple, 2.5 hours. I've had to look up help twice. I'm gonna have to look up help again. Every step I make, this game fights me. There's nothing left in this room to look at. I've tried interacting with everything. There's nothing in the other two rooms. There's only three freaking rooms! Yeah, there's... Okay, in this thing here, this menu that pops up, this is T for talk, L for look, U for use, G for get, and that doesn't actually have one, I don't think. I just have to actually come to this menu and click that. So even this thing doesn't actually help me. I've tried getting everything, I've tried using everything, I've tried looking at everything, I've tried talking. The only thing I haven't tried talking to is the guards, and they're dead anyway. Because they shoot you if you don't stun them. Three rooms. And I can't figure out what to do. gotta hate these games. We'll see you tomorrow, Internet. I will be continuing this game. I don't care if I have to have an FAQ up and walkthrough up the entire time I play this at this point. But I am going to continue this game tomorrow. But right now I need a break. So tune in then if you like seeing me frustrated as all hell. Oh, I told you at the beginning of this was going to be a shit show. Oh, I told you this was going to be a disaster. Tune in tomorrow and see just how bad it gets. Until then, Internet, take care and enjoy the games you play.